¿Cómo te va? Hoy vamos a aprender de las páginas 19 a 22. Ser versus estar. Hoy vamos a repasar la palabra ser. Ser significa to be. Vamos a conjugarlo. Yo soy, tú eres, usted, él, ella es, nosotros somos, vosotros sois, ustedes, ellos, ellas son. That means I am, you are, you, he, she is, we are, you all are, you all or they are. Ser is used to describe characteristics of someone or something. Also identification, especially material, origin, and possession. It can also be used with nationality, profession, religion, or political affiliation. And the last one today that we'll look at is time. There's more, but these are the ones that we'll study. The first is characteristics. Ella es muy maleducada. This describes the characteristic of this girl. Notice that my adjective agrees in number and gender with my subject, ella. She is very rude. La mujer y hombre son infieles. The woman and man are unfaithful. This is the characteristics that describe them. Therefore, we're going to use ser, a form of ser. For identification, you would use it to say something like, ¿qué es esto? What is this? Es un lápiz. We're identifying the pencil. Or you could say, ¿de qué es la camisa? This is used for material. What or from what is the shirt? Es de algodón. It's made from cotton. Origin. ¿De dónde es tu familia? From where is your family? Es de Puerto Rico. And possession, lastly. ¿De quién es este lápiz? Es de Eduardo. Remember these three constructions. ¿De qué es? Is material. ¿De dónde es? Is location or origin. And ¿de quién es? Is possession. All answer the same way. Este, este, este. But you'll notice this is going to be a material. This will be a place and this will be a person. Next, we have words like nationality, profession, religion, political affiliation. El señor Miller es argentino. Yo soy profesora. I'm identifying what I am, my profession. You as a student could say, yo soy estudiante. Remember that they do not use an un or una before this. Simply you say, I am teacher. I am student. Él es católico. This is a religion. Or ella es cristiana. Somos democráticos or somos republicanos if you're doing political affiliation. And lastly, just as a quick review, time. You would say son las dos y media. That would be 2:30. Or es la una y cuarto. 1:15. All right, ven aquí por favor y vamos a mirar la palabra estar. We'll contrast ser and estar because there are differences. Although these two words both mean to be, they're used in definitely different contexts. Estar is used with feeling, location, and temporary condition. Its conjugation is yo estoy, tú estás, usted, él, ella está. Nosotros estamos, vosotros estáis, ustedes, ellos, ellas están. Again, I am, you are, you, he, she is, we are, you all, or they are. For feeling, we could use it in context this way. Graciela está mala. Or Fernando está aburrido. Graciela is sick. Fernando is bored. For location, we would say, ¿dónde está Araceli? Ella está en la cafetería. Or ellos están en la capilla, chapel. Last, temporary condition. La sala de clase está muy sucia. Remember that our noun and adjective must agree. So because sala de clase, the room of the class or the classroom, is feminine singular, our adjective must also be feminine singular. Same with this. Las ventanas están abiertas. The windows are open. Abiertas agrees in number and gender with ventanas. Remember, we're using the word estar because we're talking about the condition of the windows being open. Contrast this with ser. These sentences are special in a way because if you were to substitute está for es and have the exact same sentence, instead of saying Graciela está mala, you say Graciela es mala, all of a sudden this word, sick, will change meanings and become bad, because now we're talking about the characteristic of somebody. Remember with ser, if you use ser, you're talking about the characteristics, not the feeling. So this is saying that her personality, her character, is bad. Same with this, Fernando está aburrido. Está is used for feeling, but ser is used for characteristics. So now we're saying Fernando es aburrido. We're saying he is boring. Make sure to be careful your use of ser and estar because you could be insulting somebody. And same with this. We could say la sala de clase está muy sucia. That gives the idea that it's a temporary situation. Right now it's just messy. But if we were to say la sala de clase es sucia, that means we're saying it's always inherently dirty. The characteristic of the classroom is old, run down, dirty. So remember, ser is used for characteristics, identification, etc. Estar, feeling, location, temporary condition. Make sure that you remember the conjugation of each and the context of each, and any additional vocab words that you see in your book. Hasta la próxima vez, clase, y tengan un buen día.